Well, joining us to discuss this further, Geeta Bhatt, political analyst who supports the BJP, is with us. Tauseef Ahmed Khan, who's a political analyst and a Trinamool supporter, is with us, as is Neeja Chaudhary, who will be joining us in just a moment from now. But Geeta Bhatt, let me come to you first. You know, the choice of Hindi and English by Mamata Banerjee for almost an hour-long speech, the fact that it was screened in 7 states across the country, and of course that very aggressive attack. How do you see this? Is this the Bengal chief minister, buoyed by her victory, now positioning herself on the national stage?
Well, Ankita ji, it was one is rather appalled to see. There's an echo, if you can please get it corrected.
Yes, we'll
one
get it.
One is actually upbeat. One gets appalled, you know, seeing the audacity of Mamata Didi, the way she is, you know, talking about almost everything under the sun, but fails to address the, you know, the massive post-poll violence that took place after May 2nd. The way, you know, vandalism, raping and murder of young girls just because they belong to, you know, they supported opposition party. It's something which it truly is a blot on Indian democracy. I wish she also one day chose such a platform and spoke to the nation about the condition of law and order in West Bengal. Second point is that the, you know, the way today she has come and tried to talk, you know, in bilingual and rather, you know, in Bengali, English, Hindi, trying to address a national audience. Of course, as a leader, you know, as a political leader, as a chief minister of a state, she has full right to do so. But as far as the issues that she had taken up, let us remember that even when she was Rail Mantri, Railway Minister, and the Congress government under UPA, that during that time also she had accused the government and she had said that for 4 years my phone was being tapped. I don't know whether that time also she had done this kind of, I do not recollect such
But Geeta Bhatt, would you say that those allegations, in the light of Pegasus revelations, those allegations now actually carry more weight than before, if anything?
Well, you see, that time also there were accusations that even the like Mr. Digvijay Singh, even CPIM chief Prakash Karat, their phones were being tapped by the UPA government. That time, I remember in 2012 also there was this kind of a report, and Mamata Banerjee had also accused the then government at that time. Now, coming to Pegasus, maybe Mamata Didi is not aware of how these 5 years actually were. That is why she is thinking that putting a tape on the camera is going to be able
yes,
to
that did seem a bit stopgap arrangement, if anything.
Maybe that was the kind of theatrics she wanted to add to her address.
Okay.
But nevertheless, you see, these accusations are something which are very much in the air. But the point is that from where this data has come,
Okay, interesting. You're saying these allegations have existed in the past. They've been made by Mamata Banerjee herself before. But Tauseef Ahmed Khan, do you see this now as actually an issue? Pegasus Spygate scandal, in a sense, is it an issue that can actually bring the opposition to rally around behind it? And is Mamata Banerjee now seeing an opportunity over here to, you know, perhaps go national? Is this what we are seeing today?
Of course, the Pegasus is an issue, and it is an issue which will rally not only the opposition leader, but all the people of country, because this issue affects the privacy of all opposition leader, and vis-a-vis, it tells about how callous the government of India is, or the people who is running the government of India, because they don't respect the law. They don't respect the law of the land. They don't respect the privacy of anybody. I mean, these people are opposition leaders. These people are senior journalists. These people are those who are in dissent with the BJP government at the Delhi. And Pegasus is not the only issue. We have farm law issue. We have COVID issues. We have seen how government has failed in an economy. People of India want a change at the center. People of India want an alternative to come to Delhi and take the power. And who is that leader in the country who can give that, who can make that possible? Now, Mamata Banerjee is the third time chief minister, and she's a 5-time member of parliament.
Mm-hmm.
And she is willing to take on this fight. She's a lady with a plan. Do we have any other opposition leader who has a plan like
Okay,
Mamata
fair enough.
Banerjee
That's
has?
actually an
She's.
important point that you're making, and I want Geeta Bhatt to respond to that. You know, Mamata Banerjee's brand of aggression and taking the fight to the BJP, to the Prime Minister, has clearly worked for her in Bengal. Can it translate to, you know, a national scenario as well, Geeta Bhatt? It's worked for her very well in Bengal.
Well, you see, the kind of governance that Mamata Banerjee has given, you see, we very well know, like my co-panelist was talking about the lawlessness. She needs to address the kind of a lawlessness which has with which she has been ruling West Bengal for so many years. I mean, everyone knows that the West Bengal police is just like an account, private army to the TMC party and to Mamata Didi. So it is very important, see, to become a national leader, you need to have many qualities where you are able to lead by example, and the example would be that of our own state. Now, where is West Bengal today standing in terms of economy, in terms of employment, in terms of health services? We very well know the kind of flop show it has been there in terms of COVID healthcare.
And yet,
so,
at the end of the day, Geeta Bhatt, she did get elected. Mamata Banerjee did get elected back with an overwhelming majority. But be that as it may, let Tausif Ahmed Khan, who supports the Trinamool, respond to some of those charges. Today, the BJP tried to counter Mamata Banerjee's Martyrs' Day commemorations with some of their own, highlighting the fact that, you know, their allegation that 42 people have actually died in post-poll violence in Bengal. Your thoughts on that? We heard Dilip Ghosh speaking about that earlier in the day also.
You know, these are the election propaganda which did not help BJP win the election in Bengal. People of India saw through this. People of Bengal, the state, the people of the state saw through this. And they have given the mandate in favor of Mamata Banerjee. Mamata Banerjee has given Bengal one of the wonderful, you know, the best health program in terms of Swasthya Sathi program, which has benefited thousands and thousands of people in the state of Bengal. Mamata Banerjee has given Swasthya Sathi program, Kanya Shri program, which has helped women in completing their higher education. There has been assistance from the state government financially to help complete their education.
Okay, we heard her
it was empowering
we heard
women,
her repeatedly to those schemes, which have obviously worked well in bringing her government back to power. But the timing of this, it's still 3 years to go before the general elections, Tausif Ahmed Khan. You know, is Mamata Banerjee not letting the grass grow under her feet? Why now? Is it because of Pegasus or is it some other plan? You talked about her
right.
as a woman with a plan.
She herself addressed this question in the press conference. She said that, you know, we are still a little far away from 2024 election. Mm-hmm. Still, we cannot be lenient. We have to have a plan, and that plan has been is under execution. Going forward, you need to build a consensus among all the opposition parties, because you need to have a face. We have seen in 2019 what lacked was a united opposition. What lacked was a face who people can look up to, and who would be convincing enough for people to give their vote to. Now, Mamata Banerjee is one such face, and she has proved herself in Bengal this year. So she is willing to take up the challenge in 2024,
right.
And
well,
that's how she will go out to the people. Yes.
Okay. All right. We leave it at that. Thanks very much indeed for joining us.